What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I have the 11 inch iPad Pro with 128 gigabytes of storage capacity, and I haven't unboxed it yet, so let's begin. Right when you open the box, guys, you get your iPad Pro in all of its glory, looking really good. You get your included paperwork, you get your 20 watt power brick, and you get your Type-C connectors for charging. Now, right off the bat, we can see the beautiful two cameras. One of them is a ultra wide lens and the other is a traditional wide lens. And it also has a included LiDAR scanner. The iPad can record up to 4K 60 frames per second and has a 7 megapixel camera, according to Apple. Christmas is just around the corner, and maybe you're deciding to get yourself a new laptop and can't decide which one to get. The reason I am comparing this to a laptop is because this year Apple sells a great device called the Magic Keyboard. This year, Apple added a Magic Keyboard with a trackpad. So this completely changes the game of how the iPad functions and works. Now, you can almost turn your iPad into a laptop. The reason you can't is because a laptop has much more power and has better software and etc. I could go over these topics in a later video, but this is my 1 week review of using the iPad with the Magic Keyboard. Now, don't get me wrong, Apple has designed this really well. It functions and it works properly. It even has a Type-C port on the side, which can be used to charge your device. Now, the actual device is very sturdy, is very heavy, and the case actually weighs more than the iPad. So overall, the iPad keyboard works and functions perfectly. It's just missing a few function keys. For example, the volume control, brightness control, and also the escape key. If you were to access those features, you would have to go manually into the device and switch your volume and your brightness controls. Now, this is a debatable topic, whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but this is just one of the differences when handling an iPad as opposed to a laptop. So, to wrap it all up, I really enjoy using the iPad as a laptop, but I would still get myself a MacBook because of the power and also the weight. What do I mean by that? An iPad, most of its weight is up top. It's because the up top is the computer of the device. So that means most of the weight is going to be leaning up top. That is why Apple has designed this laptop keyboard to be so heavy so that it could balance out with the actual design of the iPad. Now, let's say you're supposed to get a laptop for school and you have no idea which one to decide. And MacBook Air is also a choice. It comes a little bit cheaper than this device, but the weight is mostly at the bottom. And when using that on your lap, it can be a really great bonus when using it as a laptop. And also you get those function keys, power, portability, and capacity. Also, if you like the fact that you can go from iPad to iPad with keyboard, then this is your setup. You can use this for taking some notes, checking some photos. It has a really great camera, or when it's time for taking some emails and work, you can use the Magic Keyboard. If you're someone who just needs a laptop for schoolwork and you're on a bit of a budget and this is too much of a stretch for you, then getting a MacBook, like a MacBook Air, would be a better choice for you. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. If you have any questions, please let me know. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Take care. Peace.